What is going on, guys? Here we are, episode number 4 at the old number 7 garage. We are doing bodybuilding. We got the nose done. We got the plastic on it. All that fun stuff. So, up on the agenda today, I think we're going to do the hood, aren't we? Roof. The roof. The upper roof. We're going to do the roof and maybe sail panels and some other stuff. Either way, we got a lot of fun stuff on the video for today. Now, while I got you here, I want you to take a look at this. You see that? Right there? Take it. Let me spin around. See that? Okay. See these? See that? These are for sale. All right. We are, help support us. If you guys are interested in a hoodie, shirt, or a hat, holler at me. TimNashRacing.com, or you can go to Tim Nash Racing on Facebook. There's a shop button. You click over to that, and it'll get you taken care of. Just help support your crew. We really appreciate you. Now, drop a like on this video if you like what you're seeing. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell icon. It'll let you know when we post new videos. So, without further ado, let's get to it. What's playing tonight? First on the agenda, we got to, he's already beating me to it. Get the what is that? The
workbench
1.0. We're looking for a workbench 2.0. We just haven't quite made it there yet. But I got some sheet metal out in the truck, and we're gonna throw that on there and start getting that, not a hood, a roof. I always call it a hood. Don't ask me. Huh?
Hood's done.
Done. Yeah. Special delivery. And it came pre-bent from the factory on a couple edges, but it's right on the edge, so I'm not real worried about that. So if we make it that wide, that comes out pretty, about right there. I'd say it's probably 8 inches from the side. Half inch off that bar over there. That'd be fine. And then our sail panel will be right here. Let me look at that side. Because we can't have them, per UMP rules, you can't have too big of a bubble on them. You know what I mean? So if you do that. We may have to scoot it over a little bit and center it where it ain't got too big of a, one of these. Because right. It's got to be symmetrical. Now, I'd hate to get popped and ticked and they say, you got to fold your sail panel in. Well, first thing we're going to do is just make the hood, make the roof as big as we can. And that goes back to all this. This is some scribbly stuff I've done, but it can be 50 inches wide and 56 inches long. So we're gonna take full advantage of that because that's free aerodynamics. I ain't running no mile track, but every little bit helps, right? That's the philosophy we've always went by. Every little bit helps. So the first thing we're gonna do is show you how we're gonna make our roof. It's gonna be a two-piece roof. Because you can buy wide sheet metal, but most all the sheet metal you buy is 4 foot wide, 10 foot long, sometimes 8 foot long. But we're gonna make it in two sections, and you're gonna see how to do it here, right here on the old number 7 garage.
For how long?
Well, 56 inches, right. And then we got on the back, we can put a cap on it. Because we got spare stuff. If we got stuff that's wide enough, scrap, we'll just cap it on the back too, and then it'll save us from length. Because what we're trying to do here is make us as little as we can, make as little a footprint out of this piece of sheet metal we can, so we can save on not having to buy another sheet, And that's a tough deal to do, isn't it? Yeah. Trying to get all this. But we got lots of scrap, and we can just make a cap for the back. And we'll have a little wicker bill on the back of there, Catch that air. It's fast. So we're gonna Remember, we got to do some ciphering. We got big time cipher. So we're going to cipher a little bit. And what'd you say a while ago? We'll be back when? Huh? Talk
two,
to me.
Two and two?
Two and two. Be back at 2 and 2. Ciphering time's over. We're marking and cutting. Cutting and a covering, ain't we?
You bet.
Cutting and a covering. So we done figured out our total length. So we're going to get that cut out of there. And so that means cue montage. Your head hurt? I see smoke rolling out of your ears. Get you some of that cough syrup. Okay. So after this fancy origami project, now listen, okay, if we did this every day for a living, we'd have templates, right?
Bet we would.
We'd have templates, but what do we do? Every time we build a body, we never build one the same twice.
Nope, never.
Because I'm always thinking about something, and you're always thinking about something. Change this, change that. So we never have built two bodies that are the same. Now that's going to change because we're going to build the same damn body that's on that other car
what
out there.
Saying that, we'll find
and
out.
We'll see what happens. So what I was doing, this is basically, this piece of paper is this piece of sheet metal. And I've done all these folds and bends and stuff to figure out what I need to cut out of this. Because I'm going to have to cut a piece out of this. So we've bent and folded and our paper's free. And this piece right here is a miniature of what this needs to be. All right, so we got her figured out. And if it's wrong, I'm going to blame... I'm not going to blame him.
Blame math.
I'm going to blame... Not me. I'm going to blame... My head hurts.
Yeah.
Math? I never did do good at math.
I didn't either.
But we ain't going to blame each other, because by God, we've ciphered and ciphered till we can't cipher no more. Somebody just rolled up. Anyway, we're going to get that going. And let's see who we got here. Let's see. Let's check them out. Who that? What are you doing over there? my brother-in-law just rolled up. So Brian's going to mark it out. Let's go back to that montage. Oh, he's cracking cold ones over there. Watch him. Did you shave?
Yes, I did.
It's too cold for that, son. You got to keep that.
My wife really likes it.
Oh, yeah? Your car's all done, bud?
Yes, they are.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where are you racing at?
Everywhere.
We can go racing tomorrow, couldn't we?
We could.
No, I mean, I couldn't, but I could go ride with him and he could go racing. Gary, you got the whole crew over here, don't you?
Yep.
Holding down the fort.
Holding down the fort.
Yep. That's what happens whenever you get your race car all the way done. You got to come over here and bug me.
Yep.
Yep. I think it's...
Too.
Yeah, you might as well get up here and come over here and bend some sheet metal.
Yeah.
Here in a minute. Here in a minute, he said. He's comfortable. So if you remember, I was telling you that we got to build this in two pieces. So we can be a total of 50 inches wide. So all we did was took the 48 inch wide piece of metal, did all of our bends, So I don't know what we're at here right now. What is 43 or something like that? So we're gonna take from here and go out and make a filler panel, same way, 90, and then we'll rivet it together here. And then we'll do our other, we got our bends over there. We'll do that on this side, and it'll just have a seam here on the outside, but that's just gonna strengthen it up. And that's how I build my two-piece roots. So we folded the front, and we may come back and put this past the 90 a little bit, but we're also gonna build a cap to roll around here. Neat deal, you put your name on it and all that stuff. And then on the back, this just 90 folded up against itself, and then we'll put a little kicker up here, like with a 1-inch or a spoiler looking thing. And take you around to the other side. So what this here is, you know, it just comes straight up, has the 1-inch rise in it. And then the side, that's where you would put your filler panel, and then your sail panel will go under it, and you put your filler panel on top of it. But it's just kicked. It's got that angle in it because your sail panel is going to kind of go like this. So that's how we do it. Now we're going to get the other part done, and we're going to make our 50-inch total width. You handle that 6 foot, Johnson? What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
I can handle a six, nothing.
No.
Yeah, you. I set you up, but you did not go for it. You ever use one of these so much it don't even make a straight line right there? Look at that thing. Right there, got a big old dip in it. A lot of 1-inch marks was made right there.
Yeah,
all right, guys, that will be a wrap for today's video. And before I leave you here,
how you doing there?
Before I leave you here, you can see in the background, we got us a pretty cool shipment of stuff. Stay tuned to the next video to see what we got. All right, as always, leave a like if you like what you're seeing, and make sure to subscribe to the channel. But really, liking the videos really lets YouTube know that we're good boys over here and we're doing some good work. All right, so, and don't forget, we do have shirts, hoodies, and hats, timnashracing.com, or hop over to Facebook at Tim Nash Racing and hit the shop button. All right, till next time, guys, keep it between the ditches.